अस्सलाम वालेकुम मेरे सिटी स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम टू द एकेडमिक सेशन 2020-21। टुडे इज़ अ नाइन्थ लेक्चर ऑफ साइंस फॉर ग्रेड 5। अ शॉर्ट रिव्यू ऑफ प्रीवियस टॉपिक वाज व्हाट इज पॉलिनेशन। पॉलिनेशन इज द ट्रांसफर ऑफ पोलन ग्रेन्स फ्रॉम द एंथर टू द स्टिग्मा ऑफ द सेम फ्लावर और अनदर फ्लावर। फ्लावर्स मे बी पॉलिनेटेड बाय विंड or by insect. Today's topic is what is fertilization. Kindly refer to page number 63. This diagram shows what happens immediately after pollination. In this diagram you can see on the left side, you can see the first diagram that shows each pollen grain that has landed on the stigma develops a tiny tube called a pollen tube. The second diagram shows that the pollen tube grows downwards through the style and into the ovary. The male reproductive cell from the pollen grain travels down the pollen tube. The third diagram shows the male reproductive cell enters the ovule where it will join or fuse with the female reproductive cell or egg. So with this you can see with the help of this diagram you can see the fertilization in the flowering plants, how it happens. Seed production. What is seed production? This diagram shows how seed production occurs after fertilization takes place. Look at the diagram. The petals here and the stamina of the flower start to wither. These will eventually drop off. Wither means the petals will drop off. Second, the ovary develops into a fruit, while the ovules inside the ovary develops into seed. The fruit and the seeds together are formed. A fully developed fruit with seed is formed. You can see on the slide, refer to the image or refer to your book page number 64. And last step is the fruit gets ripened. This is the diagram of development of a full tomato fruit with seeds. The fruit protects the seeds. The seeds carry fertilized egg that will develop into young plant if conditions are right. Mature flowering plants. Here are three different examples of mature flowering plants. Kindly refer to page number 66 for more further information. Observe some mature flowering plants on the slide. Can you spot any fruit growing on them? There are three examples given here on the slide. Rice grains are dry, non-fleshy and edible fruit. Rubber pods are dry, non-fleshy and inedible fruit. Inedible means they are not able to, we cannot be able to eat. It is used in different uses. It is utilized in different uses. The third example is grapes. Grapes are juicy, fleshy and edible fruit. Going further with the explanation, you can see on the slide the vanilla pods, fruit and flower of the vanilla orchard plant. These pods are the dry fruit of the vanilla orchard plant. They give the vanilla flower flavor in ice cream and other food. I hope you all have seen this vanilla pod the first time. So what we have learned today is fertilization is the fusion of the male reproductive cell with the female reproductive cell or egg to form a fertilized egg. After fertilization, the ovary develops into a fruit and the ovules develop into seeds, which carry the fertilized egg. The fruit protects the seed. So with this we have completed the explanation. Hope in the next session we will learn about what is seed dispersal. Hope you enjoy learning. Thank you, grade 5.